Hello everyone. Let's see how to create a SubApp. Within EAE, we have two types of the SubApp object. The first implemented type is defined by the IEC 61499 standard itself, and the second one is Cat SubApp type, which differentiate in added value such as HMI, OPC-UA connector, client and server, offline data, Aviva editor, and documentation aspect. Essentially, the main difference between composite function block and SubApp is that SubApp allows you to distribute all objects within its body to the different devices, contrary to the composite function block where you can map that object only to one device. Let's start with the simplest one. In the solution overview, right-click on the SubApp node and select New Item. How you create the function block network within the body of SubApp is the same as how you do it within composite or cat composite object. Note, however, that we can't associate variables with events. Here, for the video, we won't use and delete default events and variables from our SubApp interface, and we will represent the single line engineering characterized by an adapter. Open the Function Block Network tab. Insert your blocks, such as some sensors, conveyors, motors, or whatever you need. Once your blocks are ready, drag and drop these SubApps into your application. Build your solution. Here is a little tip. Each SubApp deployed in your application is also available from the solution overview in the application node. Now let's map instances. Right-click on a SubApp and select Map. From this window, you can map all your blocks in one device. Or you can even assign each function block to different devices, such as conveyors, on M580 DPAC, motors on the ATV DPAC, and sensors on the M251 DPAC. If you don't know how to create a device, please watch our video, How to Create a New Device. You can even enter in your SubApp and map directly to each function block. You can check the mapping by hovering your mouse on a specific block. Don't forget to build your solution. Open your canvas. As we mentioned at the beginning of the video, with this type of SubApps, we don't have associated HMI aspect, so each cat instances inside each SubApps has been created from their cat HMI symbol. You will have to drag and drop them directly into a new canvas. If the application becomes bigger, it will be very long and difficult to customize your HMI. In case you have to manage an HMI, it is recommended that you create a cat SubApp. Let's focus on this second kind of SubApp. In the Solution Explorer, open the cat node and right-click on Application. Select New Item. Name it. Change its implementation to SubApp. Here is a little tip. You can even differentiate a cat composite from a cat SubApp in the solution overview, thanks to their symbols. You can fill the interface and the function block network the same way as a classic SubApp. For this video, we'll reproduce the same logic as the beginning. You can add and configure its iThis function block as in a classic cat to retrieve or even persist specific data, manage OPC-UA variables, association with Aviva. Then open its default symbol. Don't forget to build your solution. Contrary to a classic SubApp, here, from Subcats, you can create and customize its own HMI, which will be available for other instances to save you a lot of time. Save your solution. Go back to your application to drag and drop the Cat SubApp instances. Right-click on the function block to map it. As in the first type of subapps, we can split the mapping of each function block to different devices. Finally, open your canvas. Drag and drop Cat instance from your Cat subapp. As you will notice, it displays the HMI symbols you customized. That's it. Now you know how to create subapps.